final speech contestant this afternoon is Teresa Jukes with a speech entitled What's Next? With a speech entitled What's Next? Please welcome Teresa Jukes.
A lot. What's next for you? And it brings me to the high schools that I train in. I train 14 to 15 year olds in high schools almost every day for the past 4 months. And I always start the workshop with introductions. Yeah, I'm going to get to know each other a little bit better. What's your name? What's one thing you love more than anything? But the biggest question is, what's your aspiration? What do you want to be or do in the future? And oh my God, do we get some interesting answers. I had one young lady say, I want to be a forensic scientist because you know what? I love NCIS, but I hate science. A young man decided he was going to be a lawyer, but he was very lazy and didn't want to go through the 7 years of school, okay? And the one that I always get is, I'm gonna be rich, but I'm gonna marry somebody to make that happen. Mr. Contest Chair, fellow Toastmasters, that's a big question, isn't it? What's next? And for me, I have to break it down into three areas: fitness, family, and the future. I always think about being fit because I used to dance all the time. And I used to run as well. I injured myself running. That means I can't dance anymore. So I thought the best way for me to get fit is to get something else into my life. So I brought a little heartbeat into my family by the name of Coco. She is a little French bulldog, the most gorgeous little creature, has the color of my hair, which is red. They say pets and owners start to look a lot like each other. I thought I'd kickstart that. She is the wonderful creature that actually keeps me fit. We have to go out for a walk because she can't stay in. So I want to take you on a little walk that we did about a year ago. I'm sitting at my desk doing my work because I work from home, and I looked over at the little basket that held my little Coco, along with her little friend, Louie, who is blonde in color and is 7 years old. They looked miserable. It was like, please, can we go for a... And I'm thinking, no, I need to W-O-R-K. But I looked at them again, and I couldn't resist. I closed the laptop, and I turned, and I looked at them, and I went, walk? And they went, yes! And they were out of that basket and over to the door quicker than you could say boo to a goose. Well, that's what I say, anyway. We were out the door, and I thought, we'll go for a little path walk, because that way I won't get muddy, and I didn't have the right shoes anyway. So we get on this path, and we're doing the little hard walk, and they're walking along like this, and I'm thinking, you're doing really well. Little bums are in unison, and having a great time, until we turn this corner, and then Louie, who is our little friend, stares off to the right, and I'm thinking, what's going on around this corner? Coco thinks this is so much fun, and she joins in with Louie. So I'm thinking, oh my God, I'm out of control. I need to pull them back. What I hadn't realized is when we got around the corner, there just happened to be a brown and black female Rottweiler. And Louie knew exactly what he wanted to do to that female Rottweiler, because that female was in heat, unfortunately. Louie was on a mission. Coco thought, this is great fun, and I'm going out of control. I pull them back before I realize it. They're under my feet. I step on Coco. They pull this way, and I go that way. Now, keeping fit is supposed to be fun, energetic, and safe, right? Well, I realized that, hey, you know, when you have two coaches that are four-legged, you might want to find a different place to actually take your exercise. So what I learned from that is next time, we're not going to do a path walk, we're going to go to the park. That brings me to family. All my my gosh, family at the moment for me, the most important person in that family, is my 19-month-old grandson. He is the most gorgeous little creature, has dark black hair, blue eyes. He is Milo Alexander Shaw. Big name, little boy. His most favorite thing to do at the moment is to go down the slide, feet first, and hands in the air. His mama thinks that's crazy, and I'm going, no, this is so much fun, give him to me. And so that's what she does. And we absolutely have the best time. We, this past weekend, decided it was time to teach him how to go down the stairs properly. This is exercise too, you see? Yeah. I decided it wasn't a good thing for him to walk down the stairs like we do, because he's only little. So I said, you've got to go on your bum. It's bumpity, bumpity, bump, Milo. And he's going, ha, bum, bum, bum. Just about can say it. And we went bumpity, bumpity, bump all the way down these stairs. And we were being followed by Coco. So she was joining in the fun. Fantastic. He was having the best time. We got to the bottom and it was like high fives. And we turned around and did it again. What I realized and forgot was that an 18, 19-month-old actually likes to do things over and over and over. We did that for 20 minutes. So I feel really fit now, but next time I'm going to set a time limit so that it is only 10 minutes instead. So that brings us to the future. I don't know about you, but I joined this organization so I could learn to speak a little more effectively, tell some stories, and go out there in that big wide world where I could make a difference. There is an organization that is electing a new board of directors this month. It is very small. It deals with community life. It deals with charities. It deals with sourcing products locally. You know, it is that little shop around the corner. It's called the Co-op, yeah? Well, I happen to be one of the candidates that's running for that board. And if you are one of the 245,000 members out there, you have a vote. Go online, look it up, see what you can do. Not that I'm campaigning or anything. So, what about you? Do you have a goal, a fitness goal that you've been putting off to the side? Is there somebody in your family you haven't spoken to in ages? Or is there a community committee that needs your skill set? I'm going to flip that question and ask you. What's next for you, Mr. Fenton?